Yes. Now we'll discuss about the anastomosis around the scapula. First of all, we'll make a diagram. Here is. This is first rib. This is scapula. This is humerus. Lesser tubercle, this is greater tubercle. This is bisectoral groove. This groove is bisectoral groove. This groove is bisectoral groove. This is medial rib, this is that rib. And here, one muscle is attached. This muscle is teres major. This is teres major. This is axillary artery. As you know, it extends from the outer border of first rib from here to lower border of teres major. This is axillary artery. And before, this is the subclavian artery. This is subclavian artery. This axillary artery is divided into three parts. By pectoralis minor. And this subclavian artery is divided into three parts by scalenus anterior. This muscle is scalenus anterior. This is the scalenus anterior. It divides subclavian artery into three parts. This is first part, here lie deep to this second part, this is third part. From here to here, this is third part. So first part gives one branch, important branch here. That is thyrocervical trunk. This is thyro. This is thyrocervical trunk, and this gives three branches, that is inferior thyroid artery, that is inferior thyroid, this is inferior thyroid, and here is suprascapular. And angle is transverse cervical, this is transverse cervical. So three branches, thyrocervical trunk gives three branches, inferior thyroid, suprascapular and transverse cervical. This transverse cervical gives deep branch of transverse cervical artery. So it gives deep branch, runs like this. So this is deep branch of transverse cervical artery. And here, as you know, this first part of axillary artery gives one branch, that is superior thyroid. Second part, and from here to here, this is third part. First part gives superior thoracic artery. Second part gives acromiothoracic artery, and it gives four branches. One branch, acromiothoracic artery gives four branches, one branch is, here is portion of the acromion process. So it gives one branch, that is acromion branch. This is acromial branch, pectoral branch, and also it gives deltoid branch, and here it gives clavicular branch. So main concern is here acromial branch. So acromial thoracic gives acromial branch, it gives lateral thoracic branch, and third part gives subscapular. This is subscapular thing. Subscapular. Subscapular gives circumflex scapula. This artery is circumflex scapula. This is circumflex scapula. This artery is circumflex. It gives numerous branch on dorsal and ventral side of the scapula. And here, this deep branch also gives branch to the dorsal and ventral side of the scapula. And here, this is this branch, that is suprascapular, passes here above the suprascapular ligament on dorsal side. So it passes above this ligament, and on dorsal side it gives numerous branches on dorsal side. So this is suprascapular artery, and here anterior circumflex humeral and posterior circumflex humeral artery. Posterior circumflex humeral artery gives acromial branch. So you can see here this suprascapular gives acromial branch, acromial thoracic gives acromial branch, and posterior circumflex humeral gives acromial branch. So here the three branches anastomose and form the anastomosis around the acromial process. And rest part here, anastomosis around the body of the scapula is formed by deep branch in the transverse cervical. Here is circumflex scapular artery. Here is branch of this, and also here suprascapular artery. It gives branches. So all three branches, this and this, forms anastomosis around the body of the scapula on both sides, dorsal and ventral side. So here you can see this anastomosis is mainly, if you see the body, mainly between first part of the subclavian artery and third part of the axillary artery. If there is blockage from here to here anywhere, or there is compression, then the blood follow this route and ultimately it reaches to third part of the axillary artery. So this anastomosis around scapula provides alternative channel. This anastomosis provides alternative channel from where, if there is blockage here, blood passes through this route and complete their circuit. So from here it is started and goes here, continues. And another thing, anastomosis around the acromial process. Here, second part is also involved. This acromial part. If there is obstruction at this level, the blood goes through this and reaches through this and goes forward. So this is importance of the anastomosis around the scapula. Thank you.